This video is for product demonstration purposes only. Situations vary, and operators should rely on their own professional knowledge and safety procedures when conducting actual recoveries. Operators should always wear appropriate personal protective equipment and follow all local, state, and federal safety regulations when conducting recoveries. Miller Industries Towing Equipment Inc. is not responsible for any damage resulting from the misuse of equipment or any subsequent personal harm or damage to equipment or property resulting from its misuse.
Hello, my name's Tom Luciano from Miller Industries. Today we got kind of a treat for you. We've got a loaded tractor trailer that's overturned in the rest area along I-75. And we've come out here to do this recovery job. And you can see it's in mire down mud. It's been raining here, so it is very muddy. The tandems are dropped down into the low side. That's what caused it to go over. So this is as realistic as it's ever going to be. The one thing here, if you want to pay attention to what we're doing, we're taking the boom cables and we're going to four straps. And many of you think using four winches to four straps is actually the right way of doing it. If you notice what we're doing, we're taking four straps, we've run the straps underneath it, we're going to use our traveling snatch blocks. We're not lifting because it's outside of the 20 degree cone. Anything inside a 20 degree cone of the wire rope is considered lifting. Anything outside of the 20 degree cone is starting to do that pick and pull. So we didn't set blocking up underneath the outrigger legs. So the reason why we're using one winch line and a four part line is once we upright it, we start to winch it out with a 9055 in front of it. And you'll watch what happens is the rotator boom is gonna rotate, but it's going to shift within itself to keep line tension on all four straps even though we're turning it out. When you do four winch lines to four straps and try to do that, I don't care who's running the truck, line tension is not the same. Remember, we're stabilizing it and holding it while we're winching it out. And we've actually turned the rotator around. And the reason for that is you want the boom to follow the load and follow it across the tailgate. We wouldn't want to do that across the front of the cab because we don't have the stability across the front of the cab. Not only that, if something breaks or something comes loose, it's not going to be a slingshot and go into the cab of the truck. So we're rotating it with the outrigger legs all the way out. It's stable, very stable across the rear, and we have that ability of neutralizing the force of wanting to take it over. We're also going to take the 9055 to pinch down on the front of the tractor to kick it over. So each one of the straps, how are they attached? The straps are run down underneath the container and the chains are attached to the high frame rail. If you also notice, one of the things we don't do not use the container corner pockets. Many of you may say, well, I just use the container corner pockets. But you got to remember, when you're doing that, you're putting your wrecker, the winch lines, all the way out. Angles are important. Where straps, they go around the container, down underneath the container, and the chains go to the high frame rail, which is now pulling down on the wheels, getting them to dig in as we lift it. So these are all tricks of the trades. If you notice, we're using our cable chokers that we normally hang underneath the boom on our rotator series. Those are 8 foot long. They're 3/4 inch wire rope. And we're gonna run what we call a traveling snatch block between them. One other thing that we're doing here, we're using 12 ton snatch blocks. So one of the questions that come up all the time, using two 12 ton snatch blocks, should you put a master link between the two of them? And the answer is 100% no. The reason why we use a master link between the snatch blocks, that's when we're using 8 ton snatch blocks and the hooks won't hook to hook because they're too large. So we have to put a master link between them. But there's no truth to the matter that you need to use a master link between 12 or 15 ton snatch blocks. So it is okay to hook them hook to hook. And in this case, that's what we're doing. So these are all helpful hints of trying to get you focused on how to do a container and upright it using the four straps and not using the container pockets. Now we've got this all rigged up. You see in the background, we have our 1150 century rotator. And one of the things that's very critical, people make the mistake of putting the boom out too far. And the boom is up, so you get rolling momentum, But in the same token, the boom is positioned even with the outriggers. So again, we're trying to do that same thing that we were talking about during winching, and that is the angle of the wire rope is giving us compression on our outriggers, keeping the truck still. One of the other things, if you notice, we're using one winch line and the other one is hanging. You always pull the other line down and let it hang in case you need that for an ace up your sleeve. One of the things you might notice is we're taking the front axle of the truck, we're doing what we call a pigeon toe, we're pulling down on it. We're not pulling down on the axle. We've gone to the top of the tire. Always go to the top of the tire and not to the axle, because you'll leave 2 foot of leverage lost because you didn't go to the top of the tire. With that, if you also notice, we didn't use the drag winch on the 1150. We could have used the drag winch, but after we get this up, we have to keep it stabilized. So we're taking the 9055 and using the winch line off the 9055 to pull down on the front axle. Once we get this up, you watch what happens. We're gonna take the 9055, drive it ahead about 20 feet so we can actually do the winch out and follow it out. If you pay attention on the front of the tractor, you see the two yellow chains already attached to the front axle. Going around the front axle, under the front axle and up to the frame. And the reason why you take and go to the frame, come down underneath the axle is, remember, this is gonna be in the ditch. When it's in the ditch, we need to raise the low side. So when we raise the low side, the chain coming underneath the axle actually picks the axle up. So we're cradling the axle, which is minimizing resistance, and we can turn the truck and start to winch it forward. So we're gonna use two-part line on a 9055 when we winch it out. But the chains are already attached because if we uprated it, now we gotta waddle through the mud to attach the chains. So always hook the chains up first, hang them off the front of the truck. One of those tricks of the trade that's easily forgotten. Also, the dry shaft is already removed while it's on its side because we're now going to have to tow this back to the shop. So right now we're going to start the process of uprighting it, and we're going to watch what happens because Paul's operating the 1150 and he's going to start up with one winch line. That's all he has to do. The boom is set. You don't want to go up and down, in and out with the boom. So he's going to engage the winch line. It's going to start to wind up. And Mike's gonna follow with the tractor itself. So watch the winch line as Mike pulls it in. It's real, real slow because it's a 4-to-1 gear reduction because it's a 4-part line. That unit is moving right now. We're starting to tighten up the straps, the chains, everything else. If you notice, the shackles are just over the edge itself and you see the trailer starting to come up. Now realize this, those bottom tires are in mud. We could take blocking and put it in the low tire side, but as we do that, we won't get them back out. So we opted not to put the blocking down. Mike has the 9055 and he's just watching. We're keeping the tractor and trailer nice and even and bringing it up. You can see with the 4-part line going to 4 straps. And some of you may ask, you know, why not go into the container pockets? Because if you would get out of that mode of going to the container pockets, we would have a lot less accidents. Remember, this is loaded. You'll start to hear the load transfer back. It's loaded with steel and concrete. So as it comes back up again, the corners are gonna put your wire ropes out at such an angle. When you can envelope the trailer itself, you're supporting the middle, even though it's a container, and you're also making that loop with the strap, which is bringing it back to its wheels. You can see right now, gravity's taking over on the tractor and the tractor's already coming down to the ground itself. Now again, one of the things that's gonna happen is the rotator itself is doing what it's supposed to do. It's working off the side. It's at its strongest point off the side, 90 degrees. And what happens is as we engage the winch, now we're gonna be able to stabilize that and rotate and follow it out as we engage the winch out process. See, the tires are just coming down to the ground. And you gotta realize that the center of gravity, that load is all on that low side. So if we let go of it, it would naturally wanna go back over again. So that's one of the good things about what we have here, that the winch lines themselves can stay tight and we can certainly work within a safe zone by not using those 4 winch lines to 4 straps and only using one with the traveling snatch block. So at this point, we're gonna stop. It's uprighted right now. We've got it secured. We're gonna take the 9055, unhook the wire rope, attached to the front wheel. I'm gonna reposition the truck, So if you notice what we've got with the 9055, we're gonna do a pick and a pull. And what a pick and a pull is, high line's gonna be picking the low side of the tractor trailer that's in the ditch. And the pull is gonna be the right line of the truck where it comes down to the D-ring, goes out and comes back again. Now what that does, if you notice, the boom is out of the cradle itself. We've got the boom high enough, so there's no support side to side. So by running the line high and coming back to the end of the boom, technically we take the boom and tweak the boom. But by doing this and running it down to the D-ring and out, we've neutralized the boom now, so we have no fatigue on the boom itself if it's winching off the side a little bit. So this is a very important part as you get any integrated, as you get them out of the cradle, neutralize the boom so you're not pulling to the side. Very important part. If you also notice, we've dropped the jack legs down. Our jack legs are on the ground. But one of the important parts, the upper line is two-part, the lower line is two-part, so line speed is even. Jack legs are down. You can see our winch brake is on also. Remember, the rotator is stabilizing the load. If you go too much with the rotator, you can see the landing leg is just missing the ground. If we try to pull real hard, the landing leg's gonna be in the ground on the trailer, then we're not gonna be able to move it. So it's a real important part that the landing leg, as we rotate it out, okay, we let it just skim the ground. The guys are gonna start winching it out. We're gonna start doing it together. Mike's gonna start with engaging the low winch. Watch, it's a lever. It's gonna start to turn the tractor. And then at that point, he's gonna start with the low line also, so it's gonna start to bring it forward. So we're doing exactly what we want. We wanna kick that tractor around instantly so the weight starts to transfer towards us. Now Paul's gonna start to rotate the boom. You can hear the beeping noise. And really what we're doing, we're paying attention to the line, but we're also just doing a slow rotation. So we're gonna get that pick and pull is what we're gonna do. And if Mike needs to get more pick, he has the availability of taking and booming up to get more height with the 9055 to lift that lower corner out. That's one of the nice things. You never want to put your boom all the way up. You want to give yourself enough room so if you need something more for lift or even with the rotator, you're getting real close to the end of the wire ropes. You don't want to start with the boom all the way up. You want to give yourself an out or an ace, I should say. So really what Mike is doing right now, he's gonna go more with the low side and get more pick on that low side. Not go with the pull, but go with the pick. The pick is actually gonna start to take the low side and start to turn it outward. You can see it. See it turning the tractor? It's turning the tractor outward. That's exactly what we want to do. Really, the pull is necessarily really gonna happen in the end. It's more the pick right now than it is the pull itself. The more Mike can pick with that upper line, the more important it is to kick that tractor around. So all he's gonna do is he's gonna keep the low one loose a little bit and just follow up with it because you don't need it right this minute. But he's in line with the vehicle and it should start to turn that tractor even more. One of the other things you can do is take the wheels of the tractor and turn the wheels this way, which we probably should have done when we started, but the wheels are turned into straight ahead position. Now the reason why we're doing this, we're letting it be a little bit of a ridge runner because the back tandems of the trailer would get into the back jack legs of the rotator. So we're letting it run the ridge a little bit to get past us, and then we're gonna kick the tractor right almost at a 45 degree angle when it gets right about here, and that'll give us the ability of the back tires missing the rear rotator legs. We always do have another ace up our sleeve, and that is, if it doesn't wanna turn out of the ditch, we can take the low side, the pull side, run it to that opposite side and get it to kick even more. One of the things, if you take and get the tractor to kick around real quick with the rotator, you will get into those legs. And that's just from trial and error. So that's what we're trying to avoid here. But you can see the low side of the box itself, we've got the weight now coming towards us and the tractor starting to turn a little bit more. The reason why we pulled ahead so far was to get the tractor out on the black top itself. Nothing more you hate to do is start the tractor coming out, have to stop, run the tow truck ahead some more. You can see the pull line itself, really right now, isn't doing much at all, but all the weight is on that far lower side. So with it on that far lower side, picking it up, obviously that's one of the things we talk about with our integrated, is our rear jack legs have the strength because of the wishbone to take the weight on the left or the right side. Now you can see those tandems are right away from that back jack leg. And Mike's just really gonna start really picking hard on that low one and turning that tractor towards us. Now, I talked about that extra winch line on the rotator. So what that is gonna do or give us the ability of doing, once that tractor starts to come around, if in fact the back trailer is still in the ditch, we have the white winch line still free from our boom, we can actually pick the back of the trailer up and swing it into the road. That's why you want that ace in your pocket for that white line itself. You can see the snatch blocks themselves, how they're starting to disindex themselves because we've got a traveling snatch block. So if you look, one of them's going out, the other one's coming in. That's kind of the perfect catch scenario that you want, because if you notice, all he's doing is you can hear the rotation. He really isn't running the winch line very much at all. If Mike takes the line right now, the boom itself, and runs the boom out, he can actually take and start to pick that tractor up and bring it more towards the square of the back of the truck itself. And you can see it's just kind of quaveling a little bit. But if he stops with the low line and just booms out, and it'll pick it up and swing it right to the back of the 9055. You can see it's out on level ground right now. The tractor's stable and the trailer's stable. The tractor is out in back of the 9055. Paul's letting the 1150 down. The back tires are up on the apron itself. So right now we've got the scenario where the tractor and trailer is out here on the road itself. All the weight now is back off that low side, so it's stable. Right now we can hook up to it. Or if you want to take the rear line and pick the rear of the trailer up and bring it over, you can do that also. So that kind of ends our situation on winching towards us, stabilizing, rotating with the rotator, showing you the four-part line, showing you how it all works real well, and also uprighting with something that was actually in a ditch, not on flat ground, where it was actually, there was some resistance for the mud. You saw the landing leg, how we didn't want to go tight, not to get us in a pinch, and we kicked that tractor around. You know, in hindsight, you can look at every day you do a wreck and you learn a little bit more. You know, that steering wheel being locked where it was, we could have turned it and got it out a little quicker. It kind of fought us a little bit. But if you don't tie it at all, it'll kick the opposite way and give you resistance the other way. So those little tricks of the trade, hopefully you saw about the rotator, positioning it and using the extra time to rig it with a four-part traveling snatch block and having that other ace in your hand, meaning that white line free. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you on another day.